Get ready to match the stars. Joey Bishop, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Janice Lynde, Richard Dawson, and Patti Deutsch as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Johnny Olsen and friends. Are you all quite ready?
Yes.
Let's see, what plugs do we have to do? Young and restless.
Old and helpless.
Old and helpless.
I already gave.
Oh, all right.
Middle-aged and eager.
The Belle of Amherst. Yeah, Charles has directed a production that's going to appear on Broadway very soon.
Ending in Boston now. We're
right, in Boston, and it's marvelous, starring Julie Harris. What's that?
I said even as we speak.
Yes, even Boston. As we speak. Anything you want to have to say? No.
Jewish and working.
Jewish and working. Okay, let's say hello to Sandy Carlisle and Marlene Scott. Yeah. Sandy's our current champ. She improved her financial condition last time we were together by doubling her money from $600 to $1,200, and she's happy about that. You're wearing a different shirt today, aren't you?
Yeah.
Last time it said Foxy Lady, now it says, Glamour. Yes.
That's all I brought.
You borrowed it?
No.
What's that?
That's all I brought was T-shirts.
Oh, you brought a whole bunch of T-shirts. Okay. Anything you say. Now, she's going to be challenged by Marlene Scott here, whom we're meeting for the first time, and we welcome her and wish her the best of luck and ask her to tell us who she is and where she's from and that sort of thing.
I'm from Baltimore, Maryland. Right now, I'm an unemployed alcoholism counselor, not looking, just enjoying life and having a great time.
You're not looking?
For employment.
What's that?
For a job.
Oh, I see. Oh. So any job offers, hold them. See, we're not interested at all. You're an alcoholism counselor. Yes. Yeah. Do you drink?
Sometimes.
Okay. Just wanted to get the record straight here. Yes?
Brett?
No, I'm sorry.
Marlene.
We'd like you to meet Brett.
Don't be seeing her when you go back to work.
He's so bad.
Yeah, that's all. That's nothing but soda water she drinks in there. Now we'll start this game in a moment or so, but first, got to do this for you. We are ready to start this game right from the top. And Marlene, it's your choice, A or B.
A, please.
A it is. Everybody plays.
Yes, sir.
Now, here's the match game way to quit smoking. Before you put a cigarette in your mouth, dip it in blank. That's the match game way to quit smoking. Before you put a cigarette in your mouth...
Just to quit smoking?
Yes. Dip it in blank. Before you put a cigarette in your mouth. Oh, you heard it.
We all heard it, but we don't know what to do with it.
I can think of 12 answers.
Say that again. Well?
I can think of 12 answers.
So can I, but you can't say them on television.
I'm going to write down some of the answers.
Also in another language.
This was to quit smoking, right?
This is to quit smoking.
To quit smoking.
I'm going to write as many answers as quickly as I can here.
Here, let me hold the microphone.
Wait, would you repeat the question before you get...
The match game way to quit smoking.
Yes.
Before you put a cigarette in your mouth, dip it in blank. I'll read you some. No, come on, I'll put something down. What would make you quit smoking?
You got a lot of answers over there, sweetheart.
Well, I've got three, and is everybody ready?
I'm
ready. Look, I haven't even got one yet. I wrote three already.
Well, it's our first time on the show. You've been here 37 years.
Okay. Are you ready, Marlene?
Yes.
The match game way to quit smoking, before you put a cigarette in your mouth, dip it in...
Tar.
What?
Tar, T-A-R.
Tar, T-A-R.
Tar.
Okay. What'd you say?
Well, if you really wanted to quit smoking, you could dip it in gasoline, then you'd never light it, right?
Yes, right.
Every time I'm wrong, they applaud for me.
Well, but that's a good answer.
I said, dip it in water.
Dip it in water.
Okay. There's some logic to that, because you couldn't light it. Brett, what'd you say?
Right. Is that a standing ovation answer?
No, gasoline was the standing ovation.
But he got sort of a standing ovation for water, too.
Well, what are you going to get?
Well, we won't know till I show my answer.
That's right. That's what I'm getting
to. I said what you should do is take your little cigarette and dip it in a little pigeon dip.
Pigeon dip.
Right.
Comes in those little containers. You can buy them in the delicatessen store.
Or Central Park, if you're so inclined.
What'd you say, Charles?
First of all, Brett drinks only club soda.
Club soda.
Correct.
Right.
From Russia. Water.
Water. All right, got two of those. Before, if you want to quit smoking the match game way, before you put a cigarette in your mouth, dip it in blank. She said tar. What do you say?
Well, I tried to think of the ultimate turnoff, and I said the toilet.
Oh. Okay, well, that would match dip it in water. What do you say, Richard?
Is Janice going to come back?
No, not at this rate.
Now.
Pardon?
Give us a sensible answer, a really good answer.
I feel quite ill.
He's trying to quit smoking.
I borrowed a cigarette from her about an hour ago.
Okay.
I've heard of filter tips, but that's ridiculous.
No, that's
best
called,
way to no, stop.
Hers is called a filthy tip. Not a filter.
I'm not here to be topped. Best way to stop smoking is to take a cigarette and dip it in Raid.
Raid!
Also keep the flies off of it.
Right.
And the roaches.
Now, it's an unlikely possibility, but I'm hoping to get one sensible answer from someone, Patti. Is it going to be you?
That's a wonderful tie.
Thank you.
You're welcome. The brain just turned to crackers.
Don't. Oh, really?
Yeah. I said if you stick it in Monty Hall's ear.
Okay.
Sensibility prevails.
Right. Now listen, why couldn't someone have had the decency to say something like, you dip it in pepper, wouldn't that burn your mouth? You dip it in mustard, something like that. They put it in sheep dip. Anything like that.
I said pigeon dip.
You can still smoke it then, see?
The other two, a smoker would smoke them no matter what. The other two are stinky. The last one's pretty good.
Thank you.
Now, where are we here? We ain't going nowhere, are we? No, we'll get there. Oh, you got a good question. But before you get your question, we want to do a little business with America. Pay attention. Sheep dip. I don't think that's so bad. Hello? Hello, hello. Are you ready for your first round question? Remember, they're a little tougher? Listen carefully now. The emergency squad...
I've hit him. I've done everything, and he still won't shut up.
The emergency squad rushed to the Sonny and Cher show because Sonny had his blank caught in Cher's navel. Emergency squad rushed to the Sonny and Cher show because Sonny had his blank caught in Cher's navel. While they're writing... I will remind you, those of you going to be in the vicinity, Joy Bishop opens at the Sahara Hotel in early June. I assume is that Las Vegas?
Well, it's certainly not in Egypt.
Okay. There's one in Taos, isn't there? In Lake Tahoe, isn't there?
That's Sahara Tahoe Hotel.
Sahara Tahoe.
This is the Sahara Hotel.
Hotel in Las Vegas.
Right.
Early June.
Thank you.
Okay.
I think it's June the 3rd, but I'm not sure.
June 3rd. All right. Well, anyway, they're all finished. So, Sandy, we come to you. The emergency squad rushed to the Sonny and Cher show because Sonny had his blank caught in Cher's navel.
Mustache?
Yay! Mustache. All right, Joey.
It's one of the most exciting events of my life.
What?
You know what it's like to be on television 17 years and finally do the thing right for the first time?
You did.
I said mustache.
Oh! We ought to open a bottle of champagne or do something. This is a momentous occasion there.
Let's give him the Victoria Cross.
You know, we did
or
that yesterday.
Just find a girl called Victoria and line her up. No, but you know Sonny's so short.
Yes.
That he reached up for her little mouth and got her a little navel.
Mustache. Okay. Excuse us, Sandy. Charles.
There should be a nurse in attendance today. Nose.
Nose is good. Mustache is good. Janice, what have you got?
Well, I also thought he was so short, but I thought it was his head.
Not his head.
He's very small.
Does he have a small head? I've never seen him. Oh, he's a pinhead, isn't he?
Not from what I hear about him, he doesn't have a small head. He has a big head.
He has a mustache.
Oh, so they take away from his pinhead. You're right.
I don't think we should be saying these things.
We shouldn't be saying these things?
Pinhead might be watching.
Pinhead might? No. I've passed him in the corridors here at CBS. He has no idea who I am. I don't think he watches daytime television at all.
Oh.
No.
Who are you? I said he had his finger.
Oh, really?
Pressing the down button on his elevator.
I see. Okay. Now, the emergency squad going to the Sonny and Cher show because Sonny had his blank caught in Cher's navel. Sandy said mustache, and she's matched two of our celebrities so far. And now we call on Patti Deutsch.
That tie still looks great.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you very much.
I know, where that came. My wife bought that for me.
Did she?
Yeah, got great taste in ties.
This is true.
Yes.
I said he had his alimony check stuck up.
Alimony check.
So there we are with round one. Now let's go to round two. Boing. All right, Marlene.
Hey again.
Here it is. When the pilot walked down the aisle of the airplane, he made all the passengers nervous because he was wearing a blank.
I got that one.
That's an easy one. A couple of good choices here.
If I get this one wrong, I'm going to cut my throat on the air.
You got it. Terrific. There you go.
It's already written for the past
experience. Oh, wait a minute. Oh.
All right. Now.
Charles isn't riding.
Charles?
Now he is. Once he saw my answer, all got clear.
Leave him alone. Do not harass Charles. Now, Marlene. When the pilot walked down the aisle of the airplane, he made all the passengers nervous because he was wearing a...
Parachute.
Very good answer. That's cute. She said a very good answer, Joey.
I owe this audience an apology. I thought when they booed you, it was personal, but it's not.
No.
They only boo you when you don't answer what they're thinking.
That's right.
Well, I take you all back into my fold.
Are they back in the will?
Back in the will. Right. I have parachute.
Very good. One for Marlene. Brett?
He's so adorable. He told that to me during the commercial. He really meant it. He said, I thought they were really booing me. A parachute!
Hello there. Knock, knock, knock. Yes.
Parachute.
Okay, so... Yeah. Janice Lynde!
Finally, parachute!
Oh,
finally!
You got it together. It's all falling in place. Falling in place, parachute.
In interest of fair play, don't you boo me, you little fathers. Parachute.
Marlene, you got five. Now, Patti. Come on, Patti.
Oh, settle yourselves. Give a personal chance. A wash and wear parachute.
A wash and wear parachute. Okay. She got it all there. What are you going to do?
I don't know.
Now you got, there are four celebrities who play. Charles, Janice, Richard, and Patti. And the others lay out. I have a little limerick for you. Now listen carefully. There once was a Hollywood star whose life was extremely bizarre. He painted his nose and never wore clothes and made love to his wife in a blank.
Do I write?
No, you do not.
Well, just in case she doesn't win, could I say something?
What is it again?
There once was a Hollywood star whose life was extremely bizarre. He painted his nose and never wore clothes and made love to his wife in a... And the rhyming word is star, bizarre. You know, something that rhymes with those. Okay? Very good. Okay.
I would like to say I think Sandy's very cute and a cute little contestant. Don't you think
so? Oh, yes, indeed she is. She's
Thank
a foxy
you.
Lady.
And is that, is element. Monroe close to Alexandria?
It's about 100 miles.
All right, 30 Charles
miles.
Is ready, so we'll call on Sandy. Ready? Got to match all four to stay in the game. There once was a Hollywood star whose life was extremely bizarre. He painted his nose and never wore clothes and made love to his wife in a...
Car.
Okay? Now, Charles, you're first. She said car. Everybody must say car. She's got to match everyone, that is, to stay in the game.
Car!
Car. Score is now 6-3. Janice, Lynn, what do you say?
Well, I really didn't think it was terribly bizarre, but I said car.
Car! Score is now 6-4. Richard.
First thing you wrote was jar.
That's jar.
I know, but I thought what? That was a little much.
That's bizarre.
Well, that, see what I mean?
Yeah.
Big mason jar.
Yes, big one.
Kerr.
Score is now 6-5. Now, Patti, will this game end in a tie?
Or a car.
Or a car. A dead
great-looking tie.
Thank you.
I said car.
Good for you.
But there were others, too. Jar was one. Bar was another one. That would be bizarre to make love in a bar, you know. But everybody thought of car. Okay, we'll tell you what happens when we have a tie right after we tell you about this.
Today's consolation prizes are first. You can clean all the carpets in an average home for under $10 with Blue Luster shampoo and a Blue Luster shampooer. And a hot tray and a supply of Rice-A-Roni, the big flavor side dishes. So quick, so easy, saute and simmers with flavor perfection. Rice-A-Roni, the San Francisco treat. And a two-test waffle baker and grill. Snap-in Teflon grids easily convert this waffle baker to a grill exclusively from True Value Hardware Store. As one king said to Gene Rayburn, my horse, my kingdom for a blank. So be it when Match Game 76 continues in a minute.
Now, when we have a tie, we have to wipe the slate clean and start all over again with one tie-breaking question for each of our contestants, and then the one who's matched the most celebrities will be the winner, okay? Marlene, you may have your choice.
A again.
A again. Let's see what it is here. In the prison Olympics, as the prisoners disappear over the wall, the warden said, "This is the last time we'll ever have a blanking event." Now, wait a minute, think about this. It's the prison Olympics, and as the prisoners disappear over the wall, the warden said, "Well, this is the last time we'll ever have a blanking event." You know, events are in Olympics.
Oh, let's see, now you
Olympics.
See. Olympics. I got it.
Prison Olympics.
Prison Olympics.
Prison Olympics. Did you understand the question, Marlene?
To...
Think about an answer.
I got that there. I got that one. What did you say?
Okay, that's good. All right. You put yours in the slot, Joey.
Oops, sorry.
Now we're ready. And we come over here to Marlene in the prison Olympics. As the prisoners disappear over the wall, the warden said, "This is the last time we'll ever have a blanking event."
Pole vaulting.
Pole vaulting is a perfect answer. Very good. That gal has been coming up with some very good answers, Marlene has.
Terrific.
Terrific. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, the tide has turned against Joey. Uh-oh.
Now, wait a moment. She said pole vaulting, right? And you gave her a big hand. So it stands to reason, if I have pole vaulting, I should also get a big hand.
The way you started out, I was sure you were going to say something else.
Yeah, it could have been a broad jump.
Yeah,
high
that's
hurdle.
Right.
High hurdle would have been a good one.
Yeah, very good. High hurdles would have
now
been terrific.
I'd like to hear a second chorus of that. Pole vault.
Pole vault. All right. Here they go, one by one over the wall.
I hope it's a match. High jumping.
High jumping is... No, high jumping is different from pole vaulting.
See, and I know in a basketball it's larger than a softball. I know all those things,
okay.
Uncle Jane.
Now, Janice, this is the last time we'll ever have a blanking event, and Marlene said pole vault.
High jumping.
High jumping. How are you?
High
jumping.
No, high jumping is, it's not a match, but it's a perfectly good answer.
Sure,
Richard?
It's a perfectly good answer. The walls in the prison are 24 feet high. That's a very good answer. You got to be touched from the right.
Nobody you got to be vaulted 24 feet up.
Yes, they have. When you want to get out of prison, you can do anything.
And you can high jump that high.
Only if you're touched in the right place.
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury,
I feel you. Let's have decorum in this courtroom.
Oh, I'm sorry. That's
decorum
right.
Decorum in the
Dick
courtroom.
Dick is the regular. I'm sorry.
I never thought I'd see Joey, a star of his magnitude, grovel for applause. Which is what he did. You don't have to clap this. Marlene and I have something going. Hold
right.
Three for you, Marlene.
You can get a big hand. You see
I don't want one.
You should.
This is the last time I'll ever have a pole vaulting event, Patti.
Why not?
Why not?
That's right. Four for you. Now, you have to stand by for yours because we have something to do before we get to your question, and this is it. Okay. Listen, we got to cool it here. Can you wait till next time?
Yeah.
All right. Bring another upper, would you? Yes. Oh, it's interesting to see the, well, the, I mean, T-shirt or whatever you call
that
thing.
Yeah, but you see, she had Foxy Lady on yesterday.
Yesterday, today.
And the day before, she lost on Blank Trot.
Oh, yes.
Foxtrot. She wore the shirt one day too late. No one noticed that in America, 5-4-3, except me, one.
Join us next time for Match Game 76. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 76, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast. Stay tuned for Title Tales next over most of these CBS stations.